do it with me, but do the opposite again as best you can. You're in your Tai Chi posture. When we commence, we are thinking about it first, and then we're implementing it. So you're thinking, you're concentrating, you're focusing. She said, commencing form. She said, slowly drain the weight off your left foot. Put it all on your right. Elevate your heel. Put it on its toe. Get it off, completely off, so you can lift. Then place it on its toe and slowly come down. As you come down, move your hands to the middle of your thigh. Elevate both hands using that back muscle rather than just pushing up your hand and your arm. At shoulder level, you're going to reverse by tucking your wrist, stem of your wrist down. Then you're going to wrap your left hand. Chest level. At the same time, you're going to T-step. What do you mean by T-step? The capital letter T is what you're forming on your feet. All right? Now I'm going to turn around. Keep your stance, but do it this way. Okay? When we part the horse's mane, okay, I'm going to stay. Take a break. Reach over the mat like this. You're being moved to your right, so you don't want to be ahead of me. Okay? Alright, this is where we are. T-step, holding your ball. When we part the horse's mane, we step off. Can you show me a step off? Can you T-step? Can you show me a step off? So what are the restrictions or rules? When we step out, we cannot be in the same line. We have to take out an outward step so that if we drag our heel, it will be in its own plane or block. The second rule is you cannot flare out your toe because we need to do a straightaway or on the line. The third thing is, when we put out our heel, something happens to our hand, the bottom hand. The bottom hand is the lead hand. The bottom hand is usually the lead hand, not the top hand. When I step out, my bottom hand starts to follow my whole body, and then I part the horse's mane by doing this. Can you do this with your wrist? Can you do this with a wrist? Do it again. One more time. One more time. Do it now. All right. Let's rest. All right. So far, what I've taught you are four things that you need to know for parting of the horse's mane. You can never part the horse's mane unless you have a T-step and you have your ball. You can never part your mane correctly unless you do several things. Can you watch? Heel, hands, wrist. Can T-step. Heel, hands. Do you see that the heel and the hands start to move? Heel and the hands rotate. I finished putting my left foot down, my lead foot down, when my hand was already, the palms were open, and I opened my flower, so to speak, or served my meal. Okay, watch again. So look for the components that I'm trying to get you to understand. This is the T-step. My ball is 2 inches above my navel. My right hand, my top hand, is at chest level, not above that, but on top. Okay? So that's the parameter there. When I park the horse's feet, I step out away from the back foot. At the same time, my hands start to shift. I stretch. And there I am. Okay? Do it again. I do it again. What happens? We're looking for timing. The foot should not have gone down early than if I stepped out. it goes down only at the same time. You may see it come down earlier, but within my feeling of my toes and the steps of my toe, I'm still not down. Now, everybody's looking at this mean hand, but the hand that's not serving has a purpose. It's helping you balance. It's cocked. This is cocked. This is resting. This is cocked. Can you show me a cock? Right. So you have a bend in your elbow. You're still holding your balls. Your fingers are kind of curved. They're not like this, right? They're a little curved. And your fingers are apart, and they're not clenched together. So either side, you're going to have to practice it. When you practice that, it's hard. But when you actually are in play, it's purposeful, it's practical, it works much better. But to understand how to do it, you can practice it in isolation. So we're going to go over what I just talked about. All right. You're in your Tai Chi posture. Advancing forward. Slowly drain the weight off your left foot. Put it on its right. Elevate your heel. Slowly get it onto your tiptoe. When you're steady and ready, lift off your toe. Place the toe down just as slowly and gradually as you brought it up until you get a 50 feet. Without stopping, your hands come to the middle of your thumb. You elevate, you take a deep breath in to your shoulder. You tuck your wrist down. You make yourself small. You flex your knee. You exhale. You tuck your left hand 2 inches below your navel. You hold your ball in a T-sit. Park the horse's mane by stepping out with your heel, shifting your hands, turning your wrist. Sit back. Out. 45 degrees, hold your ball. Heel straight away, shift your hands. Arc the horse's knee. Sit back. Out, 45 degrees, hold your ball and tiptoe. Heel, open the knees, rotate. Finish off your step only when you stretch out. Half step forward on your tiptoe. Rotate your ball, sit on the back foot, lift up your hand, bend your foot, place your toe down, white crane spreads its wings. I have only weight on my front foot. When I rotate my ball, the weight goes back to the back foot. I lift up my hand in a certain way and then my fingers are down. But at a certain point, my foot needs to come up because my weight is on my back. If I start to rotate my ball and only my hands come up, I still have weight here. So in the process of bringing that hand up, and the weight now is my hand and my foot, that foot, I need to elevate my hands. Then, I lost my own sponsor now, and I came down quickly. There is still no weight. The weight remains in the back.